During the editing of elements, it is possible to change the orientation of the editing plane to a position more useful for our given situation. After we start editing an element, such as a roof, we can access these options in the editing plane. Editing plane orientation menu of the context menu. Three options are available: horizontal, vertical, and pick plane. The editing plane is currently horizontal, so this option is not displayed. Let us choose the vertical option, and the editing plane changes to a vertical orientation. By selecting the pick plane option, we can define the editing plane by various methods. We can move over planes of existing elements during which the cursor feedback shows what plane has been found. If we click once, the shown plane will be accepted as the new editing plane. It is also possible to define a plane by clicking on three nodes of the existing elements. Another method of picking a plane is by first clicking on a node, then clicking on an edge. After the editing plane is changed, it is possible to return to the default editing plane using the command now available in the editing plane orientation menu. Another feature is the possibility to offset an editing plane. Let us say that we want to move the selected node of a multi-plane roof to 3,000 mm above the eaves height on the hip, starting from the node. The editing plane is now at the height of the selected node. Activate the context menu, editing plane, offset editing plane menu command, then define the desired offset value using the tracker. We can now place a guideline on that hip of the roof, and the intersection point of the guideline and the editing plane will give us the point we need to move the node to. So by clicking there, we can finish the editing operation.